Manisha, good afternoon everybody. Yeah, my study is on public-private partnership in healthcare sector in Sri Lanka. I have specially focused on clinical diagnostic services, and within that ground I have covered mainly the laboratory services and CT and MRI services in Sri Lanka. So this study I have done for my PhD 3 years back. On 2013 I have ended up after doing 3 years research effort, but I have updated some data during these 2 years as well. So this as an introduction, you all know that in health sector in Sri Lanka we are just a developing country, and after ending of 30 years old war, the country, the government of Sri Lanka has a very challenging task to develop the country as a whole, not only the health sector, all the infrastructure, transportation, education, industrial sector, and everything has to develop as a whole. But health being a primary objective of the country, primary objective of the government has many challenges to improve the health sector, because mainly the diagnostic resources, those are capital intensive. So we can see that, I will show you the graphical presentation. The government expenditure on health has reduced drastically during last 10 years. At the same time, the private sector has increased their expenditure during the same time. As an example, I can say the government sector, they have only 18, all the entire country has 18 MRI machines, but out of which 13 owned by the private sector. And that is also scattered in the in and around Colombo, the main capital city of the country. And but at the same time, government serve 90% of the inpatient and 40% of outpatient. So government contribution to health and demand for the government health services are bigger than the private healthcare services. And there's an inequality of resource distribution. As I earlier commented, most of the resources, the healthcare resources, are scattered in and around Colombo city, the main capital of Sri Lanka. And the rural areas, they don't have state-of-art diagnostic facilities, as well as the whole health services are not much developed in rural areas. And the skilled staff, we have a big problem with the skilled staff in the health sector, and there's a big scarcity of healthcare personnel, human resources in the country. So the private sector always have to share the government health personnel, human resources. So that is why we have a requirement to develop the healthcare sector in the country. So we need alternative solution to develop the industry without making big contribution by the government sector. So this is just a graphical presentation. You can see the, Sri Lanka has a contribution as a percentage of GDP. The health contribution is quite low. And here you can see the private sector investment on health has increase while the government investment has reduced during the past few years, and all the healthcare resources are scattered in and around Colombo city. It is depicted in the picture, and very few resources are in out of Colombo. So my main objective is to assess the concept of public-private partnership, which I'm suggesting as alternative solution to develop the healthcare industry in the country. That is a public-private partnership is agreement between two sectors, public sector and the private sector, to improve the healthcare services or any other services. As an example, PPP, the public-private partnership concept, is widely used in infrastructure development industries in the country, mainly the highway, port and wastewater development projects in the country. So in other part of the world, there are, the PPP concept is widely used to improve the health sector as well. My objectives, main objective is to deeply study the concept of PPP and to analyze how we can use that concept in the health sector in Sri Lanka, and with some specific objectives to analyze the concept, to analyze the suitability of PPP and suitable PPP model to adopt in the health sector, especially the diagnostic services in Sri Lanka, because there are few other there are more than 7 models, PPP models, used in other countries. And I evaluated the international best practices, which model is widely used to develop the health sector as well as the clinical diagnostic services by other countries. And I have analyzed the perception about this concept. I've studied the perception of the healthcare officials and studied the perception whether they are positive or negative on this concept. So mainly this is a qualitative study which use the qualitative techniques to analyze the data, as well as I have mainly observed and participated throughout the process of clinical diagnostic services and the healthcare services. Primary data was gathered through observations, experience mainly, and the expert knowledge, interviews, focus group interviews also were conducted, and the questionnaire survey also as a quantitative part I have just included to analyze the perception of the healthcare officials. And secondary data mainly gathered from literature review. Data analytical techniques, being an empirical study, I have just used ethnography and grounded theory as a qualitative data analysis techniques. Quantitative, basically the statistical modules, use the SPSS module, the p-value and the linear regression also used to analyze the perception. And mainly I have focused on three districts, Gampa, Colombo and Gol. Purposive sampling to select the district and institutions. I've taken teaching hospitals, general hospital as well as district hospitals, and private health sector as well. 16 healthcare institutions were examined. 8 were private, 8 were public sector. And the findings, basically findings from questionnaire, I conducted a questionnaire survey. Questionnaires were given to 16 healthcare officials because they are the policy makers of the industry. And it is proven that the PPP concept is, it is feasible to apply in the health sector and clinical diagnostic services in particular, and it is appropriate, their perception is it is appropriate to use the PPP model to develop the diagnostic services, and they believe that quality can be improved through PPP model. Public sector can learn many things from the private sector. This is the perception of the official of the private and public sector. There are many requirements to be fulfilled to successfully implement the PPP, and the legal framework, government support, training, general awareness and patient condition, patient contribution also required to apply the PPP concept successfully. Private sector should play a major role in PPP under government monitoring, because they are the people who are investing on the resources under the agreement. preferred the private sector should invest on clinical diagnostic services by building new facilities. That is the perception of the majority of the participants. There is a shortage of diagnostics resources in the country. They all have agreed that there is a big shortage of diagnostic facilities in the country. During my observation, I have observed there is a big demand for the clinical diagnostic services mainly due to a non-communicable increases of non-communicable diseases as well as the aging population in the country. So government hospitals refer the test to the private sector because there's a huge waiting list in the public sector. They can't cater to the upcoming demand for the diagnostic services. Government institutes were overcrowded, and as an example, for MRI test, some government institutions, they have more than 3 to 8 months waiting list, where the private sector just they are idling with their diagnostic resources. And the private sector diagnostic resources services are expensive. Scarcity of diagnostic resources, physical as well as manpower. Government health officials work in the private sector on part-time basis, mainly the laboratory staff as well as the diagnostic staff, the people who are performing the diagnostic test. They are working part-time in the private sector because they don't have skilled manpower in the private sector. Customer service is quite poor in the government sector due to a high crowd, and the facilities are not properly maintained, and they don't have state-of-art medical equipment compared to the private sector. And that's the public sector has outdated machines and the technologies. Private sector has overcapacity with modern technology. So if they can perform 25 MRI tests per day, they just perform maximum up to 10 to 12 scans per day. So basically the private sector resources are idle. Attitude towards the work and customers by the state sector is not that good as much as the private sector employees. So those are my observations and findings related to the interviews. I have interviewed few healthcare officials in these 16 institutions, and mainly they are the top level management level. They are the policy makers in the industry. They didn't have proper knowledge on public-private partnership concept. Though they have just overheard the word of PPP, they don't have working knowledge on public-private partnership. There's no policy framework to encourage the PPP in health sector. Public sector has budgetary restrictions to develop the health sector and clinical diagnostic services. They all have for understanding that government has a budgetary restriction, so that is why they can't improve the health sector in the country. Private sector is willing to invest in health resources with government support. Most of the private sector officials whom I have interviewed, they are willing to invest on diagnostic resources as well as the clinical services in the country, but they need government support, at least some tax reduction and some guaranteed patient flow. And quality should be a parameter when implementing the public-private partnership in the health sector. Otherwise, they'll be more focused on money, not the services. Facility services should be outsourced through PPP. So outsourcing is one type of public-private partnership. So most of the people are in the view that the facility services like housekeeping, laundry, kitchen can be outsourced through public-private partnership. And there's a severe shortage of skilled workers, so these resources can be shared through this concept. Clinical diagnostic services can be improved through PPP. At last, they all agreed that they are all in the perception that this service can be improved. Literature has proven that public-private partnership, this concept is widely used in the world. And not only the infrastructure development projects, which has been
this has been introduced to the world in 1930s. So now most of the countries is improving the services and other sectors through the PPP. Demand is rising for health in Sri Lanka with aging population and the health, the lifestyle changes, and developed and developing nations are accepted the PPP as a alternative solution to develop the industry. Even India, they are using the PPP as alternative solution. Europe as well as the Asian countries moving towards PPP, and 40% of Indian diagnostic services are served by public-private partnerships. Other European nations, and mainly the clinical diagnostic services and the dialysis kind of capital intensive services are done through PPA. They are encouraging them to invest on PPP. DBFO is the most appropriate PPP model to be used to develop the healthcare industry as well as the clinical diagnostic services. DBFO is the design, build, finance and operate model. So recommendation is, I recommend to have an in-depth investigation on this concept by the healthcare officials, and make the healthcare officials, especially the policy makers, aware of the PPP concept. Otherwise, most of the healthcare officials in the country has used this word as privatization. This is not privatization. PPP is one end of privatization. So this concept should be very clear, and if not only the officials, the trade unions mostly, they should be convinced this is not a privatization, this is just to improve the clinical services in the country. So encourage the private sector to invest on PPP programs, and government has to back up, give some support to improve the private sector services. Make the trade union aware about the concept and the benefits they get through this concept, through implementing the private public private partnership model in the health sector. Set up PPP unit with officials who have better understanding about the concept, who can make the other people aware about the concept. And conduct a comprehensive study between developed country and neighboring countries, how they have successfully implemented the concept. And DBFO is a model I have identified with the literature as well as with other countries' experience, is a model which we can successfully use and adapt to improve the clinical diagnostic services in the country. And perception of the health officials on PPP is positive. That is the main plus point we have. And government can increase the access to the quality healthcare through PPP. They can invest on diagnostic and the healthcare services in the rural areas through PPP. Government is overburdened by managing non-core functions like facility services in the healthcare industry. So that can be easily outsourced through PPP concept. DBFO model, as I explained you, that is design, build, finance and operate. Mainly the private sector is investing on the facility, and the government sector is managing the facilities. Government is paying for the services. I have done a lot of huge literature review to study the concept. So that is all about public-private partnership. Thank you.